In this video, I'm going to go over some tips about how to work with the bar chart in Power BI. I think this is one of the more common ones that you'll likely use. And there are a lot of options in the visualization and formatting tabs here. So we'll go through a couple of them in this video. We left off the last video by using a clustered column chart. So that's what we're working with here. A couple things right off the bat. One thing you'll notice when you flip through different options here, we can see the axis changes. By default, it automatically determines the numbers that it will use for the increments here. But sometimes you may want to have every single option based on the same axis number. You don't want it to be switching. To do that, what you can do is go to the Appearance tab, and on the Y axis in this case, because we're looking at this vertical one, and you can see here there is a start and an end text box here, and by default it's set to auto. So why don't we put some values in here? We'll say 0, and we can set it, let's say, 10 million to make sure that everything is included. So now by setting that value, no matter what we pick here, it will always be based from 0 to 10 million. Sometimes that's more useful than having it constantly switching, and allows your users to make sure that they're comparing things always to the same level. Another thing you may want to add is the actual markers and labels for what these values represent. To do that, you could go to this data labels category and turn that on. And within there, you can decide where you want it positioned. You could have it automatically decide where it goes, or you could have it always say the inside. And depending on the selection here, we'll actually change the font color so that it's a little easier to read. We'll keep this to auto. Another thing you could do is maybe you want to have different colors for different categories. And the way to do that would be to add a legend. So why don't we do that? If we click on this and go to fields, we can see there's no legend here. So by default, it's not there, but we can add one. Let's drop color. And now each individual category gets a unique color because it's based on that legend. And the legend gets added by default to the bottom. If you want to change that, you can turn that off or on here. Another cool option here is this analytics tab. Now, analytics gives some built-in default lines that you can add to your chart. Let's say you want to see what the median value for all these things here are. All you have to do is click add, and it's going to put it there for you. So you can give it a name. We'll just shorten this to median. This is automatically picking up the measure that we have in here. You'll set this to any color you want, dashed, solid, dotted line, and include a data label. So the label will show over here. And like anything else, you can change where that value shows up. You put it on the right. So maybe we want the name and the value, median. Another one we could do is tooltips, so that when you hover over this, it gives some values. By default, it just shows whatever you have already put on the chart. So we have the color and the unit price. But let's say we want to add a little bit more. Up here, we're filtering by category. So maybe we want to put category in this tooltip. All we would have to do is drag this here, and it shows it. And we can always rename it. So they make that pretty easy as well. The last thing I'll mention here is sometimes you'll want to make the width of these columns a little bit wider. And the way to do this is actually to go into the x-axis and change these settings here, the category width, size, and padding. But if we do it right now, very little is actually going to change. And that's because what's happening is it's technically creating a bar for every category in each section here, but there's only actually values for one of them. Behind the scenes, what's happening here is there's a value of 0 for every other one. So here the black is showing, but then red, silver, yellow, blue, and these has 0. So you don't see those colors. So let's take the legend off of this so we can see what this looks like. Now, if we go back to x-axis and change this padding, we can see we can adjust how big or small the bars look by changing the padding, which is really changing what's between these. Make it smaller, there's less room in between each one. more, there's more space in between. Let's say we wanted those colors and we wanted it bigger. How would we do that? And to make that possible, if that's what you wanted, you actually need to change the type of chart. As we mentioned, it's really stacking each of them next to each other. So to make it look right, we want to change this to a stacked column chart. So what it will do is it will just stack them on top instead of next to each other. Let's add the legend back here, and we can see we're getting the output that we want, because it's really, it's stacking these, and all the zero ones, you don't see them. So the result is what looks like this. In this case, the only option is constant line instead of those other more analytical type lines. But let's add this here. Let's say, you know, we want to target, set the value, let's say somewhere in the middle, we'll say 5 million, make it black, have a data label, and just do the same thing, name and value on the right. So now we can see not only vertically the values, but we can see easily how it compares to the target. And because we made it so that the y-axis never changes, this stays more in line as well, and it keeps everything a little bit easier to read and more consistent. Last thing I'm going to do is actually hide this legend. Now in this case, it probably is unnecessary to give these different colors. I think it would actually be easier to interpret by keeping them all the same, because we're comparing the same values. But for the sake of example, we'll leave them here. That's all I wanted to show you for this video. Hopefully you found this helpful. If you did, please feel free to like, leave a comment if you have any questions, and I'll see you at the next video.